started operating kind of very simple, very lightweight pieces, a bit like John Ireland. And then during the First World War, he became a completely different man. He was a pacifist by heart. And the First World War completely changed him. This work came one of the early works that came after the Second, after the First World War. So you can hear the darkness. The name Dawn sounds quite simple, but there's actually quite a bit of darkness in there. And his later works become actually extremely dark. And at the time, he was considered English, the most progressive of all English composers. Most people didn't understand him because he became very chromatic, started using well continental devices and harmonies in his music. That piece was written for the left hand because a friend of his, or a pianist he knew, lost his right arm in the First World War. So he wrote it for, and another two pieces from that set for a composer, for a pianist, a British pianist, who lost his right arm in the war. Okay, the next five pieces are a complete change of character again. Five short pieces by Jacques Ibert, French composer, another of these great wits that France seems to bring out. This composer is rather later than Chabrier, who played in the first part of the concert. These five pieces are Tennant's Histoire, or Tales, for piano. They're little thumbnail sketches that were inspired by a set of 10 watercolours, I think they are. Either watercolours or drawings, I've never seen them. Anyway, the five pieces I'm playing tonight, I start off with the Lied with the Golden Tortoises, in case you don't understand French. I had to look that one up. Lied with the Golden Tortoises, then A Giddy Girl, the original is in English. What was the third one? Bartholomew Sup Under the Table, which is kids playing at being, I presume, Arabian kings and queens or something, or Arabian knights, something like that, from the sound of the music. Then Le Cage au Cristal, the Crystal Cage. And then lastly, the White Donkey, which is actually probably Ibert's most famous piece. Okay? Five of the Ten Histoires by Jacques Ibert. Thank you. And the naughty four, they